In this video, we are going to show you how to easily integrate STCF-A110 to make strong authentication of your devices. Let's go! Today, connected objects are fully part of our daily lives. They are present everywhere, used in our homes, cities, and industry. But this open ecosystem is exposed to security threats, such as data thefts, device cloning, or counterfeiting. It makes companies' brand reputation much more at risk. In this video, we are going to show you how to easily ensure security of connected objects using the STCF-A110 secure element. So, what is the STCF-A110? It is a secure element which is a companion chip for host MCUs such as STM32s. It provides your object with a unique identification and a service to strictly authenticate it. It secures data exchange between a device and the cloud to prevent privacy breaches and to ensure data exchange integrity. It also verifies the integrity of the application run on top of the host MCUs. Now, let's see how to integrate it. My colleague Thierry is going to jump in and to explain our demo to you.
Thanks, Laurent. So, in this demo, we will use an STM32L4 Nucleo board, and we will connect it to an STCF-A110 expansion board embedding the STCF-A110 secure elements. We will also use a software package. You can find there references for this material.
You can see the board in standalone, the STM32L4 Nucleo board, the STCF-A110 expansion board. I will now connect the two boards. And later, we will show you them working on our demo robot.
Let's start with the demo that will be split in three steps. Step 1. Download software package from ST.com. Step 2. Try existing code example. Step 3. Show how this code can enable the authentication of a robot following small code modifications. Let's connect to ST.com and we'll download the software package Xcube SafeA1. Then I click on the icon Get Software and this will download the software package into my local directory. Let's unpack code example and the library to use for the STCF-A110. I can now open code example for authentication of devices. Everything is already available and code example is fully compatible with the STM32 Cube ecosystem. Now, I can flash code example to the STM32 and STCF-A110 will be used for the authentication of devices.
I now open a Windows terminal on my PC, which is connected through UART to the STM32. Then, on the Nucleo board, I press on the reset button, and I can now see on screen the execution of the authentication of the STM32 Nucleo board thanks to the STCF-A110. An LED is turned on after successful authentication.
Before we move to the next step, we wanted to show a clip glimpse of how this authentication works. Here, you can see a high-level view on the authentication protocol flow. For more information, you can check out marketing presentation. Okay, let's see a concrete use cases with our demo robot. It's easy to use this code example to drive a more complex object like a robot. This is because we already provide all of the middleware and code example needed to install on your favorite host microcontroller. I've already shown you how to drive an LED once authenticated. Now, I'm going to show you how to pilot a robot in the same way. We just need to replace a piece of code that we used previously to switch on the LED to some code that starts the robot moving. Let's modify the main.c source code. That's done. When I click on the reset button on the STM32L4 Nucleo board, the authentication will play and once OK, the robot will start to move. Hey, we are done. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, feel free to get in touch with us.